Sweet. The tub actually pivots on this bolt right now. That's an original hole that I had always used for a mark point for as far as measuring the body. The other one I had was up here. I had two holes. Now this frame was built. This frame was built with nothing but 2x5, 3/16 wall. It's very heavy. And what I used was bed rails and pieces of flat bar and yardsticks. And I made like a cross grid across the frame so there was no way it could move around. And I did it flat on the floor. And Hank was here and he measured the whole thing. And there's one frame rail, kick-up rail. He says it's like half a degree out. That was it. So, and I don't have no frame machine or nothing like that. I just built this thing on the floor. The front frame horns, I think it was the first 12 inches or 15 inches, maybe 20, is original. It ends about right here. You can't even tell. And then it turns into 2x5. Now what I did is I had a hand grinder like that. And I actually slit the tube on the bottom all the way across. Then I grooved, I ground a channel on it, and I filled it with weld, and it started out at 5 inches, and it narrowed down to, I think it was 2.5 inches by the time you were done. Everything else from about here back is 2x5. And these wings out here now, it just seemed kind of weird that the frame would be so far in. If you got hit broadside, you'd be screwed. Of course, they weren't built for specs like today as far as getting hit by a car. But it came down to I needed air tanks. So when I was making the floor pan, I was like, hey, it'd be pretty cool if we put some wings on the frame with the same material. And since it's low pressure, it's not going to bow out. We'll make some air tanks on the side, and that's just what these are. One's for the front, one's for the rear, because I have air ride suspension in the back. Somebody had asked about the frame, so I was giving you a little details. Dad made that. That sucker is all 3/8. I made the bow tie bars, of course. The shock towers. That's just another piece of 2x5 cut kitty corner. And then we slice the end of the angle we want, and a couple washers, and the shock fits in the inside. A lot of nice cleaning, and it looks good. No big money in that. That was a piece of scrap about 10 inches long. That was actually Dad's idea. Have a good day.